Hello and welcome to my new office. This is Prairie Lutheran Church's sanctuary, and we're in the center of it, trying out some new recording technology and trying to inch our way back to worshiping in person and live streaming services. So here's a little bit different of a format of worship in the Word. It's easy to feel blessed when things are going well. It's hard to feel blessed when our life may be feeling like it's shattering all around us. So as we gather today, let's pray that we may feel God's incredible foundation that God has built for us. In Jesus' name we pray and we sing. Amen.
Our lesson for today talks about reconciliation and God pushing us toward relationships. Even all the relationships that we've broken in our lives, not only with family and folks that we don't know, but for those within our inner circles. God pushes us toward reconciliation. God urges us to seek out love. And our reading for today comes from the 32nd chapter of Genesis. Then Jacob prayed, O God of my father Abraham, God of my father Isaac, Lord, you who said to me, go back to your country and your relatives, and I will make you prosper. I am unworthy of all the kindness and faithfulness you have shown your servant. I had only my staff when I crossed this Jordan, but now I've become two camps. Save me, I pray, from the hand of my brother Esau, for I am afraid he will come and attack me, and also the mothers with their children. But you have said, I will surely make you prosper, and will make your descendants like the sand of the sea, which cannot be counted. When I lived in the Milwaukee area, I knew two individuals, two brothers in their mid-40s. They didn't get along with one another. In fact, that relationship was so broken that they hadn't seen each other in years. And I spoke to the one man, we'll call him Carl, and Carl was afraid of his brother. He was afraid every time the phone rang that his brother would be calling him. He was afraid every time that someone pulled up into the driveway that it might be his brother who was pulling up into the driveway to come visit him. Because Carl's brother was verbally abusive, he hadn't treated his brother well for years, and I'm sure Carl in return hadn't treated his brother well either. Those two brothers had been fighting for years. They'd been fighting, really, for their entire lives. And it can be easy as family to fight, because family is different than our friends. Our friends we know, but we don't know them as well as family. Carl's brother knew which buttons to press to set his brother off, and Carl also knew in return what words to say, what actions to do in order to set his brother off. And so one day I asked Carl, what would it take for the two of you to come back together? What would it take to mend this relationship? And Carl simply said, time and work. It's going to take time and work to mend this relationship. It's not simply going to happen overnight. And he also said, I'm afraid. I'm afraid to even try to mend this relationship. But I think that it is the right thing to do, to try and mend this relationship. But Pastor, I'm scared. I know that you're going to be with me, and I know that Jesus is going to be with me, but I'm scared to even attempt mending this relationship because it's going to take work and it's going to take time. That's this lesson for today. That's Jacob and Esau, two brothers who have mistreated one another, especially Jacob to Esau. Jacob earlier has stolen Esau's birthright. He's taken everything from his brother. And so in our reading today, we hear that he's rightfully afraid. He's scared to even go and talk to his brother, so much so that he's separated his family out into two camps, to two separate camps, because he doesn't even trust that Esau won't attack him and his family. He knows he's mistreated his brother so much that he thinks that Esau would be in the right to attack and injure his family. So they've been separated out into two groups. And yet God still comes to Jacob and says, I'm going to make you prosper. Even in the midst of your brokenness, I'm going to make you prosper and I'm going to be with you. And what does Jacob say in response? He says, I'm not worthy. I'm unworthy of this blessing. I'm unworthy of this forgiveness. I'm unworthy of this reconciliation. I don't know how to mend this broken relationship. And so God comes to Jacob and says, it's going to take time and it's going to take work. It's going to take courage to overcome your fears, to overcome that brokenness. But in the midst of all of it, I am going to be with you, and I am going to bless you, and I am going to bless that reconciliation. Whether it takes days or weeks or months or years, I am going to be with you. See, Jesus Christ is with you as well. Even in the midst of our brokenness, in the midst of the brokenness that we share with family and friends and the communities around us, in the myriad of ways that we've separated ourselves from God and from one another, God and Jesus Christ are still present with us, nudging us and pushing us and encouraging us to reconcile with the world around us. Not because it's easy, but because it's the right thing to do. Because that presence of Jesus Christ, that light and that love, not only lives within each of us, that just like Jacob, in the midst of our brokenness, we have been blessed by Jesus Christ. But so have our neighbors, our sisters both near and far, those folks that we've pushed beyond the margins and said that they don't belong within our inner circle. God has blessed them too. And is calling us to step outside our comfort zone to mend those broken relationships. To join our hearts and our souls and our minds and our spirits with our sisters and brothers both near and far, because that presence of Jesus Christ lives within them as well. So in the midst of our fear, in the midst of our anxieties, Jesus is with us. Every step of the way, every breath of the way. Blessing us time and time again. So that we too can move out into the world with courage and with strength and with hope in the midst of our brokenness. In the midst of our sinfulness. To know that Jesus Christ is with us. Jesus' life, Jesus' breath, and Jesus' love. It is with us now and always, so that we can move out into God's creation and bless the world with the presence and the relationship and the love of Jesus Christ. Amen.
God has given us this incredible foundation that the world is built on, the light and love of Jesus Christ. Creation bows down before the Creator, and I ask us to bow down in reverence through the renewing of our hearts. For God loves all of us and has made each and every person in God's image.
It all reveals your name. chase down my heart, all of my failure and speak 100 billion.